What is up, fellow patriots?
Good day, America.
Happy 4th of July.
Yeah!
This video's gonna be out of date by the time we get it up, but yeah!
Let's go, it'll be 5th of July. All the spread of life
and any. America first! America first!
Non-fatal. We want to build a much better, believable people, and we must do it non-fatal. Communication
very much higher. America first.
To lead by an any.
Insiders fighting for insiders.
Time to stop.
Insiders fighting for insiders.
More of
insiders fighting for insiders.
Time to stop.
Insiders fighting for insiders. America first.
Love the flow.
Yes, sir. All right. So today we are diving into topics such as Today we are diving into topics such as the recent shooting that happened in Illinois. We are diving into Joey Chestnut taking out a protester. We are diving into the Jane's Revenge attack group following Roe v. Wade's events. And much more.
Yes, get ready!
Should we start off with Joey Chestnut? I feel like that's a good hype.
Yeah, let's start off with Joey.
Joey, more like Chloe.
I am sorry today, everybody, if I don't seem energetic. I ran a 15K, so have some mercy.
I was with him.
Yes, we ran with full American flags.
He's wearing a Darth Vader mask. Neck snap.
And you can tell.
What's the sign say? Let's analyze that. Exposed midfield Death Star.
Oh, wait. Joe Biden and Jimmy Kimmel talk about that on the talk show? They were saying that we're the Death Star, the riot.
Oh. And Joe and Joey Chestnut, another Joe.
Comes
in and.
Except a different kind.
Dude, that's what Luke Skywalker needs to do.
No, you can tell that guy came in and he's like, I have the high ground. And then Joey was just like,
I am your father and I'm your death. Dude, that guy didn't even stand a chance, though. Like, he runs in. He probably didn't even expect Joey Chestnut to do anything. Like, could you imagine the shock of having the guy who holds the most world records in eating try and snap your neck?
He probably didn't even know it was Jimmy Chestnut because he can't even see through that mask. He probably, like, bumped into some random dude, and then he turns over, and it's Joey, and he's like, shoot.
Now his oxygen tank is actually going to make him sound like Darth Vader, you know, with the... Joey's just like,
just playing. Dude,
That's such a good moment.
That's insane.
That is such a great moment. All right, we're going into Jane's Revenge. All right, so as you know, Roe v. Wade was overturned. I hope you know that. If you've been living on a rock, Roe v. Wade got overturned, and this hate group, this extremist group called Jane's Revenge,
they're terrifying.
They're like a cult. They're like a cult out of like a Mission Impossible or a James Bond movie. They're like Scepter from James Bond. Or the apostles from Mission Impossible, you know? These are real-life, like, terrorists who, like, vandalize houses, firebomb buildings, and leave death threats. And this video is about them. And I think we're one of the few main groups to cover this.
Yeah.
To cover their, like... Shut up.
Well, the backstory... Here, we'll talk about the backstory.
We can't go to investigate a series of attacks on pro-life pregnancy centers across the country. An extremist group called Jane's Revenge taking much of the responsibility. And emotions are running high. So are the threats as the nation eagerly awaits the Supreme Court to release that highly anticipated decision.
Dude, this is like giving me chills.
Investigative correspondent Rich McHugh sat down with a Republican lawmaker who is demanding more be done about violence.
Hey, but it's
these
peaceful.
Are some of the first images of anyone involved
all the
with Jane's Revenge, the shadowy extremist group who has threatened a night of rage if the Supreme Court overturns Roe versus Wade.
So
the video shows
they're just getting ready for Comic Con and they don't have anything else to do, so they want to go protest.
Any fat person I feel like that supports Roe v. Wade, and like I love women's rights, just trying to get laid.
Yeah. And then they all turn feminists.
Oh.
And it's a resource center. They help people.
Yeah, what's... They help just people. Because they don't do abortions? Wait, did you see that sign? Abortions aren't safe, neither are you.
Dude! And they're getting mad at the January 6th protest.
Well, this has a cause, Jack. This happens is always good for us.
This has a cause.
So, Democrats.
Even though they're literally...
Democrats,
you're
pieces of crap.
Oh! He's a piece of shit.
They're people like this.
Even the freaking liberals are like, this is out of hand.
Dude. Anyone who supports violence like this?
This guy reminds me of Cooley.
He looks like a fat Jeff Daniels. He does.
Yeah, that's so true. This looks like a white comma. Hey, you gotta have some heads.
Look at them, they're wearing like red robes.
Dude, I'm sorry to say this, but that literally is like the KKK.
It is. Well, we're saving women, of course.
It's yeah, for
the KKK,
cause.
We're saving women.
They're saving women. No. What about the men, huh? Why don't you save men? Oh, wait.
Look at them. Look at them. They're a piece of fat craps. Should we just pause that frame for a second? Mm-hmm. If this computer will allow it. Hey, let's get back. Hey, let's just look at them.
And I love how... Dude,
look
are they them. Are they all men?
No. I think that one's a woman with leggings.
But what
with
is
like,
a woman?
That's true. That one's a woman with leggings. I think the one with the red shirt, he seems like a basement dweller.
They're all goth.
Couch crusher. let's just call them the Suicide Squad because they're goth.
Yeah. That one was pretty good, Ty.
I wish I'd nickname this dude.
Which one?
Let's name him Fat Man, like Batman, but because he's in dark. He's Vengeance. Because they're James Revenge, so...
I'm Vengeance.
Yeah, James he says... We'll call him Fat Man. Alright, that's it. That took us 100 clicks and me figuring out a computer, but we did it.
And I wish we did it.
Alright, and now here's the part where I went in. I've been harassing them on Twitter, and I'm going to get them on a call. I'm going to try and get them on a conference, like a call. I'm going to call them from a private number. Of course, I'm not giving my real number to these psychopaths.
Oh, they will do some messed up crap.
No, they'll probably come here. But yeah, I told them, like, you better not be touching my town or I'm coming after you.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, he's retaliating? That's not allowed.
Freedom of speech? What? I thought we were the only ones that had that.
Nope. Yeah, we've been recording. Alright, let's see.
Dude, that is terrifying.
Dude, look at the sign. Look, this one says... If abortions aren't safe, then neither are you. Jane's Revenge.
And what is that? Is that like their symbol?
I haven't seen that symbol. I feel like I've seen that symbol before.
That's terrible. No. Anybody who thinks this is right has lost their mind.
There is people that think it's right. They think it's right to kill a baby. Dude, this is straight up satanic, like cults.
This is awful.
This is like stuff from like a horror movie, like freaking Blair Witch or something.
Yeah. You're going to see people crawling up the walls, and they're going to be like, Jane's Revenge.
Just a found footage movie with fat nerds breaking into your house and spray painting it. But yeah, they firebombed like a some lawmaker's office, I think. Oh, I'm not sure. We might need a fact check. I think they did firebomb someone's office. I don't know if it was a lawmaker.
Yeah.
But it was, they definitely firebombed an office.
Oh, well, it was talking about an organization that was pro-choice.
Yeah.
That was, like, helping.
You mean pro-life?
People. Yeah. Sorry.
Come on. That was, like... That'd be funny if they were attacking their own kind.
I know, yeah. They, like, chuck the firebomb, like, mid-throw. They're like, shoot!
I saw a group of socialists, like, a video where all these socialists met up. Uh-huh. They were, like, tearing into each other, like... The guy, like, gets up, like, can you keep the chitter chatter to a minimum? And then the guy, like, starts talking and he misgenders someone. The woman's like, actually, you misuse their pronouns. And they start, like, arguing with each other. That's what happens when you get this group of the biggest idiots in the world in one room.
That's what happens when you literally just don't care about reality. Because then nobody knows what to say.
Alright, should we watch Baymax's tampon shopping trip?
No! Don't ruin Disney for me once again. Actually,
I am Baymax, your personal pedophile.
Personal pedophile assistant.
You're Aaron. I didn't even know what a tampon was until 2 years.
Excuse me, which of these products would you recommend?
Well, these are the tampons I usually use.
He's a freaking robot.
Thank you.
I prefer pads. They're more comfortable for me.
Thank you.
I always get the ones with wings.
Thank
you. Get scented and bleach free if you can.
Thank you.
Yo, my daughter loves these.
Thank you.
These might be easier if it's her first period.
These are really environmentally friendly.
He's carrying tampons. And you can tell he bought those tampons with welfare money.
Hey. Let's see, maybe he's taking it to his aunt. To Hero's aunt. What's the best case scenario?
There isn't a good case scenario. But that's so stupid, like...
That is stupid.
Why would...
Why?
Why would a robot need a tampon?
It doesn't make sense. And why do we need to show that?
What kid found that entertaining? Like, even the left was like, yeah, that was a little too much.
Yeah.
It wasn't, like, pro-gay or anything. I mean, there was the trans guy they threw in for no reason, but...
I miss the days of
other
when...
Other than that, it wasn't that pro-gay.
I miss the days of when it was all magic and you could basically leave, like, I don't know, reality for a second to just be a kid. But no, now you have to know about all this crap.
I see that part where, you know, he puts on the armor...
Yeah.
Instead, he's, like, putting on a vagina. And Baymax's like, I see. I fail to see how this makes me a better healthcare companion. And I see Hero like, I fail to see how this makes you look less awesome.
Yes.
I don't know if I quoted that right. Somewhere like that. Did we watch Elmo getting his vax?
Yeah.
Dig it.
I haven't seen this one.
No, Daddy. Oh, the super duper bandages just like Elmo.
You were super duper today, getting your COVID vaccine, Elmo.
Yeah, there was a little pinch, but it was okay. Elmo was
a communist.
Daddy and baby David there with him. Baby David, where are you?
I had a lot of questions about
Left
Elmo
the
getting the COVID
where I was
vaccine.
Was laying in bed the next day, barely able to move because the vaccine
the right
almost
decision?
Lost.
I talked
me.
To our pediatrician so I could make the right choice. I learned that Elmo getting vaccinated is the
honestly,
best way to keep himself, our friends, neighbors, and everyone else
be
healthy and enjoying the things
Rob,
they learn.
Elmo, you're an old man with a diaper fetish.
Baby David has a question.
Yes,
come here,
since what, then
oh,
needs.
Come here, son.
Elmo loves you, Daddy.
I love you, too.
Dad, can I get the COVID vaccine? This says no kid ever.
Dad, can I get a shot, please?
Why was that? And why did that seem like it was talking more to adults than kids in a kid show?
No, it did. Because the dad looks at the screen and goes, I had many questions about the vaccine for Elmo.
But why was that kid-centered?
It was?
It seemed...
I thought it was towards the adults.
But it's an Elmo...
That doesn't make any sense.
You don't
sense.
See adult. You don't walk in on your parents late at night and they're watching Elmo.
Yeah, yeah. They're like, I got sick of the news. I needed to go watch some Elmo to figure out what shots are good for my kids.
I can explain.
It's definitely a credible source. Elmo has many facts.
Elmo says facts don't care about your feelings.
See Cookie Monster? Me love hormones, I'm a mama.
Oh, and when he turned into the, like, veggie monster or whatever.
Oh, me love fruit. Fruit's very good in my cookie tummy. It's like, no!
Michelle, you ruined our school lunches even more.
Freaking Michelle Obama. Alright, so you probably know about the shooting. And I'm sorry, this kid's audio is annoying. The kid's acting like a vlogger when there's a shooting going on.
Wait, there's a kid?
In the, yeah, that film, like, you hear the parade and you see everyone running.
Uh-huh.
How old is he? It doesn't show anyone shooting, but the kid's like, I'm getting this on video! You know?
How old is he?
I don't know, he's like 9.
Oh, what?
And he's like pumped about it.
That's why we shouldn't give kids phones.
But yeah, this is it.
Why is he so stupid?
I didn't record that! I can't believe I actually...
Todd, no one cares that you actually recorded it.
Yeah, they're watching the print.
Ma!
This is the only video I can find. Yeah, I wish.
This one is hard because we haven't called the guy yet, right? So we don't know what his motive was.
It was a 4th of July parade.
I believe.
Alright, but first I have to say, we are not going to go too much far on assumptions. So don't take everything we say 100% serious. Take it with a grain of salt because we're probably not right.
Yeah.
Because we have no idea. These aren't facts.
Nobody knows. No one has any idea.
These aren't facts. All we know is someone shot down a 4th of July parade. We can have assumptions based on the stories. Like, it says the shooter was a male, 18 to 20 years old, with a long black hair, small build, and was wearing a white shirt or a blue t-shirt.
Yeah. So, like, we have no idea,
The long black hair was expected, though.
Yeah.
They're always kind of like that, with, like, the goth.
Yeah, so, like, he could have either been really depressed, or something could have happened, and maybe the 4th of July just made him, you know, even more mad. Maybe. Who knows?
I feel like that was an anti-American move, though.
Because
I don't know.
At a parade, maybe it was just because everyone was together, and
that was a good moment to attack people.
Yeah, but nobody knows. My heart goes out to all the people that died.
Here's the police report. Here's the audio from a police officer. Here, let me go back.
An individual, they have a description, but he's wearing a large yellow back.
Action.
The person we're looking for is going to be an individual, they have a description, but he's wearing a large yellow backpack, like an army style backpack. And they are currently at Central Train and checking the basement at Sunset Foods. That's all I have at this point. I'll give you guys something.
Can I just take a moment to say, the Democrats hate shooters. They hate shooters and they blame the left, the right for it. But yet, there's that Jane's Revenge group.
Yeah.
And they're saying it's for the greater good.
And they say
violence is the only way.
I hate shooters too. Like, I hate shooters
too. No one...
No one likes shooters.
Barely anyone likes shooters.
But why do you blame it on the... Why do you blame it on the other people? Blame it on the person that shot.
Mm-hmm.
Don't take it out on the other people just because they're easy targets to take it out on.
Guns don't kill people. Teaspoons don't make people fat.
Yeah.
Spoons don't make people fat. Cars don't drive drunk.
We all have a choice.
Yeah. I think we need to find more effective ways to help people mentally.
Yeah, with that Jane's Revenge group, I can tell this story, this shooting story is going to get told across the nation. But that Jane's Revenge, they're going to find some way to blame it.
Yeah.
And until we get further, like, information on that shooting, then we can start making assumptions.
Last I checked, 6 people died, 24 were wounded in the shooting. in the 4th of July parade in a Chicago suburb in Highland Park. The gunman apparently opened fire on the parade goers from a rooftop using a rifle that was recovered at the scene. Police believe that there was only one shooter and warned that he should be considered armed and dangerous. The firearm was recovered at the scene and it was a rifle. So the guy is armed and dangerous. He's at large, last I checked. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, the death rate. I did update this. The death rate is at 6 dead and 30 injured.
Oh, it's 6 dead and 30?
Yeah, it went up since I wrote that up there.
Yeah.
I went back and
how did the people just getting trampled and stuff from?
No, he's shooting them with a rifle.
How many shots did he get off?
In a city like where we live, no one would get the chance to shoot like that many times and hit people before actually getting hit by a civilian.
And I want to know where it was at in the parade. Like, because you know how there's like cops
mm-hmm.
Throughout the parade?
Mm-hmm.
So I bet they got to the evidence very quickly. And I want to know how the guy got away. Because there should have been cops everywhere. So that kind of confuses me. And it makes me a little angry that he got away. He may have had a plan, but...
Do you think... I feel like there is a motive behind this. Because if there wasn't a motive, he would have committed suicide.
Yeah.
Yeah. There had to have been a plot behind this.
There had to have been something that he was protesting or
he was standing up against something.
Something. Because he probably would have... shot himself or something.
That's usually the case.
Yeah.
But I went and researched Chicago, Illinois' laws on guns.
Uh-huh.
And that I found is an article called AP News. They said, while Chicago has strict gun laws, it is not illegal to own most guns, including handguns. But in the city, guns considered to be assault weapons, such as certain semi-automatic rifles and ghost guns, are privately made firearms without serial numbers and are banned in the city. So most extreme rifles are banned in that city.
Yeah.
They didn't specify what type of rifle it was.
They said it was just a hunter.
But there's no way with like a bolt action you can cap that many people.
There's no way.
There's no way.
I don't know if you guys have tried to shoot.
I'm a deer hunter.
Yeah, we both hunt.
Yeah. There's no way.
There's no way you can't get that many.
I mean, if he did, I hate to say it, but
that
it's impressive.
That is impressive.
That is impressive. But there's no way some.
It
random
had to have been some.
There's
sort
no
of
way
semi-automatic. Some random
kid in Chicago, just
got a bolt.
You'd
action.
Have to be a pro with a bolt. That had to be a semi-auto, and that's banned.
It had to have been a semi.
This also said the facts following that last week's shooting in the elementary school in Uvalde, Texas, where a gunman fatally shot 19 children and 2 teachers. Politicians and social media users claim that Chicago, Illinois, is an example of an area with strict yet effective firearm laws that don't stop gun violence. And that's a fact. I hate to bring it into it, but I'm already preparing you guys for when they... I hate to bring politics into this, but I already want to prepare you guys for when they do bring anti-gun stuff into this, that we can say that this city was already strict on that, and it didn't help.
Yeah, it didn't. Like... we don't know.
We have no
idea. It could have been a bolt, but I highly doubt it was.
No, there's not high of a chance.
And if it was a semi-auto, then...
If it was a bolt, everyone had to have been standing still for such a long time.
Yeah, and you could have seen... You saw in the video that everybody was running within 5 seconds.
You hear a lot of close... In the video, you can hear gunshots. They're pretty close together, too.
Yeah.
I mean, you'd have to be insane if you were with a bullet action firing that quick, hitting that many people.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a miracle only 6 died in a parade like that. Uh-huh. Luckily, it was open area where people can run.
Yeah.
I saw a thing where a dad hit his son in a dumpster
to
get him
really?
Away from the shooter. There's another one where I heard a family got separated, and the woman was talking about, like, her thinking that she's going to lose her kids.
Uh-huh.
It's sad stuff, and mental illness is highly real.
Yeah.
And has to be taken seriously. But when you throw guns into this, when you throw our safety into this, and cake it and disguise it as your protection, but in reality it just removes your protection, then I start to have a problem with it.
Yeah. You can't, and I feel when people blame them it on guns, it is a reaction to cowardice.
Mm-hmm. It is.
Because they're finding a way out. They're finding a way out.
Yeah.
It's a simple way out. It's you can ban guns, but you can't ban people.
Yeah.
So it's just, it's hard.
I think you need to get into classes and teach more safe stuff. And
yeah,
I think more people should look out to kids. Like teachers should go up to kids if they look depressed. And
yeah. And like we were saying in the last episode, that one teacher took that suicidal kid out for ice cream and got in trouble. And then that one teacher takes the 16-year-old to the drag show and doesn't get anything.
Can we also talk about how most these people are on social media all the time right before? Like, they're never some, like, jock, you know? They're never like, he was a straight-A student and didn't expect him to shoot up the school. No, it's always like...
No, yeah.
They were quiet. They were kind of keeping to themselves.
Yeah.
And usually before these events, they tweet or post or...
They do something. There's
Snapchat
always...
or whatever. They write to some friend that they're going to do some serious crap.
There's always a beforehand. You can always see it coming.
Mm-hmm.
You can always see the change in them.
Because most of the stuff doesn't happen without evidence before.
No. It's not...
That's a rare case.
Yeah. And there have been some cases.
Yeah, most shootings I've heard about, though, they're like, get on, like, Instagram or something, and they post, like, everyone watch out or something like that.
Yeah.
They post, like, something edgy like that.
Something weird. And people just take that lightly.
I mean, there's one time in one of my classes, this girl next to me was drawing dead bodies and stuff. This was in physics.
And I'm sorry, but...
But, like...
We're starting to normalize that stuff. It's starting to be
like, that's
cool.
That's the way you express yourself. And I'm like, no. You can't. And were the insane ones for wanting to keep guns? No, people are getting way too into death.
Yeah,
I'm
in
sorry.
TV shows and movies and in just everything.
I mean, Marvel's trying to make violence more normal, you know?
Yeah, they're trying to go into R-rated with gore and
that new Doctor
violence.
Strange, yeah, they're trying to make more and more edgy.
It's kind of screwed up, yeah.
And suck. Don't watch it.
And I'm trying to think of... I had to bring this into it, but anime, a lot of those kids watch anime and that. Have you seen that? Some of that stuff is pretty cool.
I have a statistic about
Death
Note.
So that's one anime that is pretty screwed up, and people, kids, see whenever there's a death scene, they're like, oh, that was a sweet death. Mm-hmm. It's like, dude, we're taking death lightly, and it's a cruel thing. It's a bad thing.
I don't have an exact statistic, but I do know that there is actually a statistic out there that says most mass shooters come from fatherless homes.
Yeah.
Without, like, a father. Like, it doesn't even have to have a house with a dad. It has to have a dad that actually plays their role as a dad, you know?
Yeah.
Democrats are trying to destroy the family.
That's the importance
issue.
Of family.
That's the issue. Democrats are trying to destroy the family. They want to destroy it. They want to make it, like, two moms, or they try and say single moms. I do... My heart goes out to single moms. I don't know all the circumstances.
Yeah.
But moms can't parent one kid most of the time.
Like a dad.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry.
Dads,
built differently.
Dads are meant to be around. And if a kid's running around being like, dead buddies, you know, the dad's like, hey, shut the heck up. Don't get into that crap.
And it's the same with a mom. A dad can't do some of the traits that a mom does.
Yeah, exactly. Moms are more nurturing and dads whip kids into shape.
Like, hey, I am appreciative of my dad and of my mom, but they taught me different.
They taught me different ways.
But
yeah, that's why there's meant to be... And everyone's saying, you know, there's different gender. I'm like, but the two genders are there for a reason.
They're there.
They didn't just magically appear out of nowhere. They're there for a reason.
And then people are talking about, all the generations are getting worse and worse. Well, then find something that's wrong. Oh, I know what's wrong. The family is starting to get
torn apart. I mean, the divorce rate is higher than it has been all time.
It's awful.
And you wonder why this crap's going down. Yeah, because the divorce rate's all-time high. Like, Uvalde, the shooter lived with his grandma.
Yeah.
The shooter was like, he didn't live with his grandma, but he had, like, a mom and was with his grandma a lot, but I don't think he had a father figure, if I can remember correctly.
With everything, it always starts from the base up. You have to start with the family, and then you can start going into communities, you can start going to states, and then you can start with our nation. But it all starts with the family.
Should we wrap that up?
Yeah, I think that's a good one.
Yeah, I think we did good. Well, guys, thank you for watching.
Happy 4th of July, everybody!
Yep, so long. Farewell. Goodbye. Vaya con Dios.
And wave your flag.
Goodbye. Farewell. So long. Vaya con Dios, good luck, wish you well, take it slow, easy come, girl, easy go.
Update.